إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد الله تبارك وتعالى He says in his book النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم. The interpretation of the meaning of this ayah from the book of Allah, from Surah Al-Ahzab. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم is closer to the believers than they are to their own selves. النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم. The Prophet Muhammad ibn Abdullah, ibn Abd al-Muttalib, ibn Hashim, ibn Manaf, ibn Husayn, ibn Kilab, ibn Murrah, all the way to Adnan, to Ismail, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is closer to the believers, to I, myself, and to all of you, and to all the Muslims around the world, from the first time the first Muslim, Abu Bakr, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, accepted Islam, and Khadija, radiallahu ta'ala anha, accepted Islam, from those Muslims, those believers, all the way into Yawm al-Qiyamah, the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, is closer to you than you are to your own self. No matter what type of believer you are, or what, no matter what type of Muslim you are, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is closer to you than you are to yourself. He loves you more than you love yourself. He tries to protect you more than you try to protect yourself. He cherishes you more than you cherish yourself. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is more dearer to you than you are to yourself and your mother and your father. Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah al-Hafiz, Abu Fida, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said about this ayah, قَدْ عَلِمَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى الشَّفَقَةَ رَسُولِهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَلَىٰ أُمَّتِهِ وَنُصْحَهُ لَهُمْ فَجَعَلَهُ أَوْلَى بِهِمْ مِنْ أَنْفُسِهِمْ وحكمه فيهم مقدما على اختيارهم لأنفسهم. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he says that Allah Ta'ala, he knew how compassionate his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was towards his ummah and how sincere he was towards his ummah. So he made him, Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is above his throne in a manner befitting his majesty. Because Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we don't believe that Allah is everywhere. Like the people who misunderstand التوحيد of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like the Muslims around the world who have the wrong understanding of Tawheed of Allah's asma wa sifat, His names and His attributes. We Ahlul Sunnah, you Ahlul Sunnah, you believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above His throne in a manner befitting His majesty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah ta'ala, said, so Allah made Him closer to them than they are to themselves. And He decreed that His judgment among them should take precedence over their own preferences. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, decrees, when a matter has been decided by Allah's Messenger, then you're going to place what He said over what you believe. You're going to place what He said over what you think. You're going to place what He said and what He commanded over how you feel. Because He is closer to you than you are to yourself. And He knows what's best for you better than you know for yourself. He knows how you should conduct yourself in your business. He knows how you should conduct yourself and your family affairs with your wife and your husband and your children. He knows how you should conduct yourself with your mother and your father. He knows, and He taught us how to conduct ourselves with the Jews and with the Christians and with the Mushrikun, the pagans, like the Hindus and the Sikhs and the Buddhists. He knows that. So Allah made Him awla bil mu'mineen, awla bina min anfusina. He made Him closer to us, more protective to us, more cherishing to us, more devoted to us than we are to our own selves. And if you don't believe this, if you don't really believe this, then you don't understand the meaning of Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you really don't believe this and you don't accept it, then you don't understand Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. You don't really understand that second part of the first pillar of the Shahada. Buni al-Islam ala khamsa. Shahadati an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Islam is based and built and constructed on five pillars. The first is two parts. I bear witness that there's nothing worth their worship as a deed except Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. Part of your belief, part of your shahada, your testimony, that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah, is that you believe that He knows better for you than you know what is better for yourself. In all your affairs. Not the prayer, not just fasting, not just zakat and charity, not just hajj, not just fighting in the way of Allah. How you conduct yourself in every single thing. Whatever He says, you accept it. Whatever He says, stay away from this. You stay away from it. Because He is closer to you and more protective of you than you are closer to yourself. Shaykh Abdul Rahman ibn Nasr al-Sa'di, rahimahullah ta'ala, who some say al-Sa'di, he said, يُخْبِرُ تَعَالَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ خَبَرًا يَعْرِفُونَ بِهِ حَالَةَ الرَّسُولِ صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وبركاته ومرتبته فيعاملونه بمقتضى تلك الحالة. Sheikh Abdul Rahman al-Sa'di rahimahullah, he said in his tafsir of that ayah, النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is closer and more dearer and more nearer to the believers than they are themselves. He said Allah informs the believers. That's me and you, inshallah. He didn't say He informs the Jews. He didn't say He informs the Christians. He said He informs the believers. That's me and you, inshallah. He said Allah tells the believers by which they may understand the position, the martaba, the position, the status, the makana, the manzila, the rank of the Messenger of Allah. Allah is informing us of the rank of the Messenger of Allah. Why? Because we really don't know it. We really don't know it. We say it with our mouths, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, alayhi salatu wa salam. I love Prophet Muhammad. You have a little keychain with a heart on it. I love Allah, I love Muhammad, I love the Prophet. Do you really love Muhammad? Do you really know Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do you really follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Allah is telling the believers something by which they may understand the position and the status of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so that they may interact with him appropriately. The companions had to be told who he was, so they wouldn't treat him like they treated anybody else. And he's dead now, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So now we know, we need to know how to deal with the Prophet. He's not here, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we're not rubbing shoulders with him. He's not in the masjid. We don't see him making the salah. We don't see him when he's fighting in jihad. We don't see him how he's dealing with Aisha and his other wives. He's dead now. Allah was informing the companions how to deal with him. So how do we deal with him now? We deal with him by looking at his hadith, by looking at his sunnah, which is inside the vehicle called the hadith, from Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim and the Sunan of Abi Dawood and the Jami' al-Tirmidhi and the Sunan of Ibn Majah and Nasa'i and the Muwatta of Imam Malik and the Muslim of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. We look at the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so we should know now how to deal with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullah, he continued, وَأَلَّا يُعَارِضَ قَوْلَ الرَّسُولِ بِقَوْلِ أَحَدٍ كَائِنًا مَنْ كَانَ. We're going to say this again. The Arab brothers, alhamdulillah, they understood it. For those brothers like myself who's an American, born American, my language is not Arabic. You Bengalis, your language is not Arabic. You Turkish brothers, you African brothers, that's not your language. The Arabs sitting here, they know what I just said. وَأَلَّا يُعَارِضَ قَوْلَ الرَّسُولِ بِقَوْلِ أَحَدٍ. What the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said cannot be overwritten. It cannot be overwritten by what any person said. Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi, Imam Ahmed. We don't care who he is, what sheikh he is, what mullah he is, what maulana he is, what imam he is, what alim and ulama. You can't take the statement of the Messenger of Allah and put it under sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the statement of Imam Abu Hanifa. That's just like saying if the Prophet was standing here right now and he said something, and Imam Abu Hanifa and Nu'man ibn Thabit, for those of you who are Hanafi, do you know his name? Abu Hanifa's name was Nu'man ibn Thabit. Some of you say you are Hanafis, but you don't even know his name. You don't know when he was born. You don't know where he died. You don't know who he studied from. You don't know who his teachers are, but you say you're Hanafi. If Imam Abu Hanifa was sitting right over there right now, and the Prophet was right there, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Imam Malik was over there, Imam Shafi is over here, and Imam Ahmed was over there, and the Messenger of Allah said something. We all listen. He just said something. وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيُّ يُوحَىٰ. He does not speak of his own desire. It's revelation of which he's inspired with. Would it be proper for any of you to say, excuse me, Imam Abu Hanifa, I just heard what the Prophet said, but can you tell me what you think about that? Imam Malik, can you tell me? I know that he's a messenger of Allah, but I just want to hear what you have to say. Imam Shafi, can you tell me, you have anything to say about what the Prophet said? Imam Ahmed, do you have anything? It's not permissible to do that. But we do it. We bring you a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who is closer to you than you are to yourself. And we will take the statement of Imam Malik and push the statement of the Prophet away. Take the hadith of the Prophet and push it away. Say, no, my madhab said, I don't have to put my foot next to yours in the salat. I can have 4 fingers, 3 fingers, 5 fingers. But the Messenger of Allah said, تَرَاسُوا لَا تَخْتَلِفُوا وَتَخْتَلِفَ قُلُوبُكُمْ. He said, straighten the rows and make the rows tight. Put your foot next to the brother on the right and the left of you. And don't become divided, or your hearts will become divided. No, my man has said, no, I don't have to do that. Imam Malik said, you don't have to do that. Imam Shafi says, you don't have to do that. And Nabiyu awla bil mu'mineen min anfusihim. The Prophet is closer to you. He knows better for you, better than you know yourself. That's the message of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam al-Sa'di, he continued. He said, وَأَنْ يَفْتُوهُ بِأَنْفُسِهِمْ وَأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَوْلَادِهِمْ وَيُقَدِّمُوا مَحَبَّتَهُ عَلَى مَحَبَّةِ الْخَلْقِ كُلِّهِمْ. Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullah, he said, they should sacrifice themselves. We should sacrifice ourselves, our wealth, their children, and put love for him before the love of everybody else. Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. We say it every day. We say it in our salah. We say it every day. But do we really understand what it means? Imam al-Sa'di, he says, وَأَلَّا يَقُولُ حَتَّى يَقُولُ وَلَا يَتَقَدَّمُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ وَهُوَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَبٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ كَمَا فِي قِرَاءَةِ بَعْدِ الصَّحَابَةِ يُرَبِّيهِمْ كَمَا يُرَبِّي الْوَالِدُ الْأَوْلَادَ. When the scholars have said, may be summarized by the statement of Imam al-Sa'di, those people who say, they go to the point where they say, they're going to place their statement above his statement. While the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is the father to the believers. Why is he father to the believers? Because Allah says in that same ayah, وَأَزْوَاجُهُ أُمَّهَاتُهُمْ, because his wives are their mothers. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is our father. And your father knows better than you children. You may not think so because you're always on your laptop and you're always on YouTube and you're always looking and tweeting Twitter and Facebook, and because you have a little bit of education now, you think you know better than your father. You think you know better than your mother. Your parents have lived 20 and 30 and 40 and 50 years longer than you. Your parents know better. Are they perfect? Your parents are not perfect, oh young children. Your parents are not perfect, but they have lived life. They have khibra. They have experience. They have ilm. They have knowledge. They have age. And they're trying to guide you and direct you. Would it be right for you to say, you don't know what you're talking about? I go to New York University. I know better than you. That's not right for you to say that about your parents. I learned on YouTube. I Googled it, Baba. I know better than you. Even if you know better than them, they're here to guide you. The messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is our father. Yurabbina, he's educating us. He's cultivating us. He's teaching us. He's rearing us. He's disciplining us. He's teaching us that which we need to know to do what? To get a bachelor's degree? Is that what the Prophet is trying to do for us, sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The one who's closer and more dearer to us than we are to ourselves? To help us get a master's degree? Is there anything wrong with a bachelor's? No. Is there anything wrong with a master's? No. Is there anything wrong with a PhD? No. There's nothing wrong with IT and medicine and technology and science. There's nothing wrong with this. And Muslims should have it. But this man, Muhammad ibn Abdullah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's giving us a tarbiyah that you can't buy and you can't learn in any university, anywhere around the world. Because he's teaching us that which will get us closer to Allah. And put us in the pleasure of Allah. To see the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he has a face. Allah has a face befitting his majesty. His face is not like the face on this clock. His face is not the face like a monkey. His face is not the face of a human being, but Allah has a face. And we want to see his face. And the only way we can see his face is that we accept Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in every single thing that he says. And everything that he tells us to do, We do it. سمعنا وأطعنا. We hear and we obey. Everything that he says stay away from, we stay away from. But in الله الحمد. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الأمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد. The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, مثلي ومثلكم كمثل رجل أوقد النار فجعل الجنادب والفراش يقعن فيها وهو يضبهن عنها وأنا آخر بحجزكم عن النار وأنتم تفلتون من يدي. The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, in this hadith that is collected by Imam Muslim on the authority of Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari رضي الله تعالى عنه, and a similar hadith from Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu found in the Sahih of Imam al-Bukhari, Muhammad ibn Ismail rahimahumullah al-jami'. The Message of Allah, listen closely brothers, he said, and you dear sisters downstairs, the likeness of me, meaning the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the similitude, the likeness of me and you, meaning the believer, the one who he's closer to us, to you, than you are to yourself. The likeness of me and the likeness of you is that of a man who lit a fire, and then grasshoppers and moths started falling into it, and he tried to push them away. Let's mention it again. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, the likeness of me and the likeness of you is like the likeness of a man who lights a fire. And then the grasshoppers and the moths start coming around, because we know the nature, how Allah created the insects. There are certain insects that when you have a light, whether it's the light in the ceiling, the light of the lamp, or fire, they start going closer to it, because the insects don't have ilm. Despite what the kuffar say, the kuffar say that animals have knowledge. That's why they need this lamb. Animals don't have knowledge. Animals have instinct. Human beings and angels have knowledge. Jinn have knowledge. Animals and insects have instinct. They have instinct. It's called al-wahi al-ghareezi. It's instinct, instinct. So the grasshoppers and the moths, because they're attracted to the fire, the light, they're stupid. They don't know that the fire can burn them. So they go towards the fire. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, that I am like that man, that when the moths and the grasshoppers, which is me and you, we're the grasshoppers and the moths, we start going towards the fire. All these things in society, the women, the drugs, the river, the interest, gambling, intoxicants, we start going towards it, cheating people, lying, being deceptive, not keeping our promises, killing people, slandering people, backbiting people, all those things that lead to, and now, to the hellfire. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one who is closer to us than ourselves, he's trying to grab us by our hudas. He's trying to grab us by this right here on the izar, on the longi. Trying to get us to not fall into the fire like those grasshoppers and those moths. And you know what we do? We push his hand away. That's what the Prophet says, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We push his hand away. He's trying to protect us from going to the hellfire, and we're like those grasshoppers and those moths. No, I want to jump in. I want to jump into the fire. I mean, it's nice, it's light, it's warm. I want to jump in there. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Nabiyyu salawatullahi wa sallamu alayhi wa barakatuh, awla bil mu'mineen min anfusihim. He is closer, more dearer, and more protective to the believers than they are to themselves. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, we wish we could continue this khutbah Maybe on another occasion, inshallah, we will continue a part two of this khutbah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us really understand the meaning of Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we ask Allah to not make us of those people, those believers, who push the Prophet's hand away. Because if you push the Prophet's hand away, brothers, you're going to fall into the fire. And the fire is real. The sun is the hottest known substance in this dunya. And the coldest fire in the next life is hotter than the sun. We ask Allah to protect us. اللهم ادخلنا الجنة اللهم اجرنا من النار هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وحافظ الصلاة